They deciphered that one correctly.
So this one not out of reach yet, but they need to move quickly here, down by more than a score. Operating out of the gun, Flacco. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2. Give him 30 yards there. Setting to throw, Flacco. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sacked back around the 8. Angelo Blackson in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. Flacco to throw. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And this is going to be covered up by the Giants. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time, and that'll bring up second down.
There are a good number of coaches that any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
Steps away to his left. They find some open field here. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
And caught by Chad Johnson. Past the 20. And he is on the run now. Chad Johnson. And all the way in. Touchdown. And the Giants add on to their lead.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. And they're going to be set up in excellent field position up past the 45.
There's no downplaying that we all knew that this was a critical possession. And to get a return like that to start things off, that's the spark that they needed. That's the spark they were looking for.
Flacco. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Now he'll spike it here with 20 seconds to go on the clock. Pressure mounting, Flacco. And it's caught. He's got it for a late touchdown, but probably a little too late. It would take a miracle of epic proportions if they're going to pull this one off. Coming from where they were, they knew this was going to be tough, but they got the touchdown. Now they need the miracle, the onside kick and a little extra.
Yeah, and you have to get the onside kick and not have the ball bounce around a lot and eat up time. You want to be able to grab it, possess it, and get your offense out there for what you just termed a miracle last chance.
And this will be recovered by the Giants, and that ought to just about do it. The risk-reward of the onside kick, when you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them, and field position leads you to that type of play calling, whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep. those types of things. Nowadays, giving up that type of field position, the advantage has switched to their opponent.
Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And, Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break.